just remembered something. Yes, I was alone in the kitchen, and I don't know where my mother was. And there was a German that I hadn't seen before, knocked on the door, and I went to the door, and he offered me his camera, an Agfa camera in a case, and if he could help himself to the mangles. The mangle is like a big beetroot. We had a heap of mangles for the animals, and that was when they were hungry. I was afraid to get a film for the camera after the war, because I thought they'd think I was a cherry bag. So there was a dog called Paddy that my brother had. He was a beagle hound, and he went walkies. And he got a girl into trouble, a dog, and the owner of the she dog said that he was the father of Peter, and Peter was the runt of the family, and my brother gave it to me, Peter. And one day it was missing, and we had bales of hay and straw, and I thought he might have got behind them, you know. And somebody said they'd seen a German put him in a milk can and just walk away with him. That's when they were hungry. I never got over there. No. Lovely dog. And he was small, and he followed me everywhere. I was crying. We went into a field opposite our farm, and my mother was consoling me, I suppose. And I remember crying when I heard the bombing going on, and we had to put white flags on top of each building, and my brother wasn't fast enough. Oh, and the Germans commanded our fields, and we could see the German on guard and with a small gun. He was just guarding it. We could see it from our backyard. It's just up the road. When you think that the Germans were our neighbors, weren't they? Well, the Germans took the lorry. My father had a farm, and the Germans took the lorry and the car. We never saw it again. Saw them again, and the wireless. They must have taken the wireless. I used to go through the camp to get the cows, and my mother didn't stop me. They were very pleasant. They either said hello or they didn't say anything at all. And we had a cottage at the end of the farm, and the Germans commanded it, a five-bedroom cottage. And they had the girls in there. And when they left, they always found was a single bed and a single bed. And one quite a nice looking German used to go there and see his girlfriends. She was dark, and I saw her wheeling a pram after the war with a blonde baby in it. I went to the Helvetia private school, and my mother thought that I wouldn't see any Germans in the countryside, so she sent me to St. John's Elementary School, and I saw more Germans than I'd have seen in the town. And Miss Haynes used to come. Miss Haynes was the head of the school, and she used to come home to glean after the, you know, we'd cut the wheat, and the glean what was left, just ears of corn. And her sister, she brought her sister with her, and I used to have piano lessons, and Miss Nora, sister, she used to come in, she used to come to Les Ormes to teach me. So I don't know if she charged for that or what. But my mother always gave them a bottle of milk to take with them. Oh, I had my I left the St. John's School, and I went to the Helvetia again, because Miss Haynes kept on saying I should go to the Helvetia. And there was, I think she was a slight relation, I don't know how, and an old lady, and she used to give me my dinners. I took her the food, and she cooked it for herself and myself. And she lived in the parade. She had a large family, and the father had been sent to Germany because he'd sold some cigarettes or something. And oh, she sent one of the girls, a teenage girl, with a big cart that she'd borrowed, and my mother filled it up with even faggots of wood, you know, and food, and all kinds of food. So I saw them, we didn't have them working in the fields, but we saw them pass with a German with a gun on his shoulder, one at the front and one at the back, and the poor Russians, they had their feet wrapped up in rags. They were it was awful. And they kept going like this, you know, to have food, but we didn't have much ourselves. No, I wouldn't like to see my children go through that again. And it must have been awful for grown-ups, you know, with children like my brother and I. We were only children. It must have been very worrying for the parents, because they didn't know what was going to happen.